right. It's that time. We've come down to our final couple. So let's take a look at their video, shall we?
The drama continues to unfold in the first ever Dancing with the Local Stars here at Caesars. The following earn their way to this round by dancing with a new partner and preparing in less than 1 week. They received a 29 from the judges for their efforts. What will the dance floor reveal about their cha-cha tonight?
Having only had 3 rehearsals for last month's competition, the following delivered a striking performance of a battle for the remote control. This time, they continue the battle. Battle for your votes. This time they dance to remain alive in the competition. Dancing the cha-cha, please welcome Barbara De La Fuente and Richard Darby.
Lucy, I love Lucy. I love Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. We have our quarrels, but then, oh, how we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus and I'm her man. And life is heaven, you see. 'Cause I love Lucy, yes, I love Lucy. And Lucy loves me.
I love Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. Sometimes we quarrel, but then how we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus and I'm her man. And life is heaven, you see.
Lucy and she loves me. We're as happy as two can be. Sometimes we quarrel, but then how we love making up again. Lucy kisses like no one can. She's my missus and I'm her man. And life is heaven, you see. 'Cause I love Lucy, yes, I love Lucy. And
Lucy, that's so ridiculous. Barbara De La Fuente and Richard Darby, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, fantastic. Okay, for our last set of comments, we're going to start with you, Bevan. What did you think?
That was great. You remind me of Mark and Maria, where you crafted such a beautiful story. Well, full of humor and full of great technique and great footwork. Good job.
Okay, Mike Foster.
I thought your frame was really good. You carried that frame through the whole thing. Great job with that. And another thing I noticed was your footwork. Now, when you do the cha-cha, there's a transition between what they call the chassés, or the small steps, into the long steps where you're traveling. And your footwork was really good because your hips moved with your feet, which made it a great transition. I think it was a great performance. Good job. Excellent. Thank you.
Cindy, how about you?
I just love the two of you on the floor. I love the stories you bring to your choreography. And Barbara, you just fit that role so wonderfully. And the only thing that I would have liked to have seen was just a little bit more use of the floor. But in all, I know the cha-cha doesn't move as much, but it was great. Thanks so much.
And now, to make a long story short, Sir Victor Green.
I love the nostalgia trip. And for the older ones among us, remember Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball, and it told a story. And I would say that when it comes to cha-cha, there's been a lot of entertainment tonight. But when it comes to the actual technicalities of cha-cha, I would say that you are probably the closest to this evening to a proper cha-cha. And I loved the comedy ending. A good ending is always worth an extra point from me. Always.
All right. Now I'm going to send you backstage, and you're going to sing the Babaloo. All right.
Oh, can we turn on that?
Okay. So, we're almost at the end. I just want to remind you once again, the next round will be June 16th, right here at Caesars. And July 4th is the semifinals, the big gala. Crystal Gage will be singing. There's a big buffet dinner. And then the finals later on in July. So that's all coming up, coming to a head. One more thing I wanted to remind you of. This Sunday afternoon at the Scottish Club, Starlet Rose and Guy Darnell performing. Tickets are just $10, and the proceeds will go to BWTA. Let's throw it over to Susie one last time.
Thanks, Mark. Now, another volunteer that makes these evenings possible is Jules. She's from Faces by Jules, and she's been the volunteer doing all of the makeup for everyone you've seen in the show. So thanks so much, Jules. You're doing a great job. Now, what did you think of their dance?
Well, I think aside from wowing the audience, I think Barbara really wowed the pants off of Richard.
Literally. Literally. Now, I want to know, how many faces do you have your hands on per show?
Well, at the beginning of the event, the first show was approximately 35 people. And today, there was probably about 25.
So lots going on. Now, what's your favorite part about being involved in this event?
The excitement I get from the dancers after getting all dolled up and how great they feel being all glam and...
Yeah, and my last question, what guy here gave you the hardest time about wearing makeup?
I would have to say that would be Victor, because he thinks he's too perfect already.
That's a good answer. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Susie. Okay, we're going to go backstage one last time. Carrie is there with Barbara and Richard.
I am. Barbara and Richard backstage here with me. Barbara, what did you like about the cha-cha this month?
Well, it's a very hot dance, sexy, and very fast-paced, so it's a lot of fun.
Great. And Richard, how's it been preparing with Barbara? You know, short-term, you guys had to throw it together and nail it. How did you feel about that?
I had to buy a ruler, so I did hit her legs to make sure she followed well. So it was good. Once we get that out of the way, no. It's been really good. She follows extremely well and is able to pick up and not stop in places when she gets stuck, so she's been phenomenal.
And how are rehearsals? Do you guys see eye to eye? Or?
Well, if we do this. But otherwise, we're pretty good, yes.
Well, let's find out what the judges gave you guys for scores.
All right, scores. Yeah, we can't forget about that. Let me see. Who should we start with? Well, Cindy, why don't we start with you on the end?
9.
9.
Victor.
10.
10.
Bevan.
10.
Yeah. And Mike.
9.
Ooh. Oh, come on, 38. 38 out of 40. That's not bad at all.
38, guys? What do you want? You guys are the last ones. You get to pitch to the audience. Who should they vote for?
Number 9.
Number
9 for all time.
And now it's your turn. It's your turn to decide the fate of all of our contestants this evening. Back to you, Mark.